Really? You just... You waited for me to get here. I thought that was the rabbit that was bouncing around over here forever. And now... It's mucking up the place. You blow it for everyone! Now this whole place has to blow up. You realize that, right? Right? Whoa. I didn't mean to do that. Hey. You are the one who scared me. You are the one who scared me. Okay. Hello, this is RedMcNed, and welcome back to the saga. I've got a couple... one specific thing I want to do today. I've been really distractible, but there's one thing that I need to do, that I would like to do. And before we do that, we got to get distracted with something else. So, I have this lovely enchantment. Something that I may have mentioned, that's making a giant map wall. And we have enough sugarcane for it, and I think we have enough cows for it, too. So we need to make item frames, and we need to make maps. Since we went mining before, we should have all of the little materials that we need. So I'm going to go ahead and make maps. And to do that, you need compasses and you need iron. I don't think I smelted any iron, so I'm going to go do that really fast. Unbeknownst to you. Except that I just announced it, so I... Never mind. So apparently what I did is I thought ahead and I had a thing already full of iron that was nice and smelty. So that's all ready for me here. So all I need to do is make a bunch of compasses. I'm going to try to map out this area here and most of the mountains actually, and maybe a little bit of the forest surrounding it. So it's a bit ambitious. I'm not really sure how many I'll need. So I'm just going to make like 15. That might be overkill, but I'm going to do it. So making compasses is this way. Maybe I should just make all of those. Just a huge waste of whatever. Luckily they can stack. I'm going to go ahead and make 15 of these. And paper is thusly the thusted. And when you put two and two together, you see what friendship is for. Or something like that. I think it's when you're resizing maps. If you shift click, you try to go from a map size lower to a map size that's higher. It'll actually keep the lower map size, so you actually have to take it out of here. I know, it's extra work, and no one wants to do that. I certainly don't. But if you ever get a weird glitch that happens like that, it's because of that. Unless they fixed it recently, I don't know. Oh, I gotta sleep. It's always a really big moment when you open up your first map, so... I'm going to make a lot of room here, and I'm going to try to stay organized this whole time. I'm going to dump off some things so I have more room. So what we're going to start off with is a bunch of low-level maps, and what I mean by that is maps that are the smallest scale size. And I'm going to keep all of the extra maps over here, maybe even over here, and I'm going to make like a... I'll show you what I do here to kind of keep everything nice and organized. But I'll have a nice 4x4 grid that I could almost use like a map wall. Just have to remember which maps go where. So, cool. So that is our first map. Arrows pointing where we are pointing. So if we're pointing straight up, that's the direction. I actually like to, whenever I make a map wall, make sure that, like, if I put this down somewhere, I don't have a picture frame, I can change that. Bit of a nomenclature error. I meant to say item frame. But whenever I put down a map, I'll just use this tree. I like to put it this way because then I'm facing the direction everything is. Like that lake just above where the green part says, "You are here." That's that lake. And down and this way, there's a building looking thing. That's the building looking thing right there. And it even has the cow pen there, the water there. It even has the, I don't know what to call it, that thing in all of its glory right there. So we're gonna make, actually, I'll go ahead and show why this is kind of weird if you don't have it facing that way. If you do something like this, then that's cool, but this lake is there, so it's not quite the same. This place here is actually there. You'd think that this little lake would be right behind you, but actually it's just straight to the right. So it kind of throws things in a weird direction, so I like to just avoid that altogether. Apparently I like avoiding picking up the things too. So another thing I have to warn about. If you have item frames and picture frames, they will go in the darndest places once you break them off. They'll just boo, just like, later, I'm out of here. I'm not telling you where, because you're not cool. They'll do stuff like that. So, all of that said and done, I think I've said everything I needed to say. I'm going to use this map to figure out where to go. So, I'm just going to open a map in each new region I go to, and I'm going to decide whether or not it needs its map or not. And I just said map a bunch of times, and I know that if you say the word map enough times, map, 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 any word starts to lose its meaning. So I'm going to try to avoid that. All right, we're officially off of the last map. It's unavoidable. I'm going to put this here because that's the middle. We're going to be up one, so I'm going to make a map of this new area. Do a little right click. Yep. There we have it. It's the new map. So it's got that little area in the top right. I'm going to walk toward it. I love the fact that you can walk and see where you're. If you tilt the camera up, you look away from the map. If you tilt the camera down, you look at it. I think that's just a nice thing. So I'm going to go. Just don't be like one of those people that looks at their cell phone all the time and then like falls down a cliff. It's really embarrassing to be that person and just don't do it. So we're off of this map again. Go a little ways. Just to keep track of where I am, this map is below it. This is above it. And right now we're in this quadrant right here. So that's where the next map will go. And there we have it. I'm going to, do what I can to fill it out so it's not incomplete. But I'm not going to go this way very much. In fact, if I stop here, it'll probably fill out. It's going to make a liar out of me, isn't it? Okay. Now time to go down. And after I pass this line, that's where the next one will go. Whoa, whoa, oh, God. Oh, see, that's why you can't just like have your head. Too many things are close to my face. Too many things. Just everyone needs to back off. This plant needs to back off. This cow, this tree, this map. The sheep's gonna be in my face pretty soon. I know it. I know it. You're coming over here. So this one goes here. Sorry about that. I got a little edgy for some reason. Edged out. So, same thing. Blah 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 blah. And we're gonna go sideways. And there's the piece of the house. So that means that there should be the house coming around this corner. Yep, there it is. Maps don't lie. But if they do. All right, so we're off this map, which means we're actually here again. So just to make sure that we know what we're doing, we can look at this map. And the weird thing about maps, if you leave a map, it'll keep the dot where, like, we're not supposed to be at the top. We're supposed to be at the right. So sometimes the map gets a little silly. Just a little bit silly. A little bit silly. So we're not gonna worry about that. I think we're gonna head toward the mountain now. Unfortunately, I really wish the dot wouldn't get stuck at the same spot. So if you really don't want that to happen, you can go to where you think the edge is and then put away your map and then walk forward a little bit over the edge. Just enough that you're guaranteed there, and then open the next map. That way the dot isn't stuck like mine is. That's too bad. You know what? Maybe I can duplicate the map later if that becomes an issue. Oh well, we'll just have to use our powers of observation to see that this is the next area that doesn't have any map yet. And I want to go over here. I want to get on top of this thing. I'm going to put away the map because it's taking away my view. I know where I am. I don't need no stinking map. And I don't need to ask for directions. What else? I don't know. I don't know all the stereotypes. Oh man, it's already nighttime soon. All right, so this one goes here. And we should be around here. So let's get the next map. Boom. Oh, that was close to not being on the map. That was really close. Oh, I didn't know it was all covered in snow. That's pretty cool looking. And of course, the sun's going down, so I have to head back. I'm gonna fill out this map first, and then I'll head back. All right, we're back, and it's daytime. And look at that, because I put it away before I left the region, the little thingy still works. It's a technical term, thingy. So I'm gonna go forward to where those trees are, and I'm actually gonna go up a little bit. Please don't be anything that blows me up out here. Please don't let there be anything that blows me up out here. All right, so I'm gonna do this the pro way and not the amateur way. We were here. We're going up to here. So I'm gonna wait till I'm definitely across into the next area. I'm gonna swim across this. That's how I'll know. And when I open the map, it'll be a map. Let's do it here. Yep, beautiful. It's always interesting to see if there's any weird formations on these two. And same thing. This one goes here. We're going to this area now. This can sometimes get pretty complicated to keep track of, so sometimes you can trial and error it and just hope that if you have any duplicates, you just throw it away. But I kind of like to wind around and wait. I don't think we have any pumpkins yet. Well, don't mind if I do. Don't mind if I do. It's kind of a weird looking little stream. This stream's saying, don't mind if I do. Just kind of rolls in here. I think we can make pumpkin pie actually now. I'm not entirely certain. All right, we should be far enough over. Wait, what? Oh, that's why you don't Yep, we are. So then we're gonna go back down. I'm not really sure how far. How far out, man? I don't know how far out we're gonna go. Like, as far as this direction. Well, I did say it was going to be a giant map, so better live up to that. I think I have. We'll see how many maps I have after this. So I'm gonna. Maybe I'll cut it off here and start doing the rest. Right, so there's the mountain that looks kind of like a frog, and I guess that means that we haven't really gone too far away. Sometimes it helps to even put the empty maps where the next one will be. All right, so that's where the really cool mountains start to happen. I don't know, maybe I can grab those too in this thing. Wait, that's down. Okay, yeah, that is down. I can't look down because there's a big old map in my way. Maybe I can get this spot. So I'll be going there. That one goes there. There, everywhere. Know, it's not easy finding paths up this thing. All right, so here's the next one. What the? Oh yeah, there is lava. Okay, that red spot is lava going to the ocean. And I guess there's a I guess there's a frozen lake on top of this thing. That's kind of cool. I think I have to go down. Yep, so that means that this stuff is going to cramp my style. We're here. This is what this map is. We have to go down to this one. It's almost useless, but not quite. I don't know, do I really wanna I pretend that I'm not bugged by little idiosyncrasies, but that I need to fill out the map. All right, now I'm gonna go this whoa this way. Oh no, the sun's going down. I get a little bit more. I'm just gonna have to be risky. There's no way I can make it back. I am a coward! Oh, I'm gonna have to fight things off. Okay, let's take a look. See the creeper over there. I might be able to sleep. And of course they don't go away. They never go away. I have to make them go away. All right, let's use some strategy. I learned this from Star Wars. I have to get the high ground. Where did it go? No idea. There he is. Ah, oh, I missed him. I missed flinging the sword at him. Because of that, I have a blowny uppy mountain. How am I gonna salvage this? Just gonna look like a blown up mountain. Alright, let's see if I can. Nope, I can be as stupid. Yeah, that's what I meant to do. Wait, what the hell? It's an invisible spider. Okay. All right. Okay. Get my skills back. Need to redeem myself. Lava, huh? Lava, huh? Oh. Down a level. Oh, hello, Mr. Strolly Stroll. Double Strolly Stroll? The Endermen are busy today. Maybe I can,
My word. Umar.
Oh dear. Umar. I don't know why they're out at daytime. I don't know what they're doing out here. Anyway. I think we're still on this map. Yeah, we are. I don't know how much further. I think we're gonna go this way now. Yeah. Yeah, good, yeah. Definitely, yeah. Oh yeah, I kind of forgot where this was. Sort of like a weird hilly kind of roof forest. Whoa. Almost went on an involuntary caving expedition. Alright, that looks like just a bunch of forest. Alright, that is the end of... Wait, just so we keep organized. There, it's all organized. So, let's not touch that much. Alright, so now that we're back... Oh yeah, I could probably do the wheat. So now that we did... Oh wait, we have to sleep. Alright, now that we slept... Oh, you know what? I should probably breed some more cows. We have the maps. So now you're thinking, what do we do for the next part? Well, isn't it obvious? Actually, I don't know either. Alright, so I've been looking at the that little hole that was created by that creeper and thinking, well, we need a place for the map. Why don't we make, like, a place for it? Like a secret place. And I'm going to tell you right now that everything I do is... I like to say it's a reference. One could call it a reference, one could call it a ripoff. You know, it's really... I'm not going to argue semantics with anybody. But you'll probably notice that I want to make a secret place that has pictures on the walls and a door that leads to different worlds. And it may be from a video game. Seriously, everything I do is like... Nothing I do is original. I'll just go ahead and be the first to say it right now. Playing Minecraft, not original. Having a Let's Play, not original. Running commentary, not original. Making video game references. But it's how you do it. That's where I come in. It's all about the context. I haven't forgotten about my mission statement. Everything needs to have context. I have not forgotten that. And I want to wrap all these things into a nice, coherent thing. And when I think about how coherent it is, I have to be spinning at the same time. Because you can't be coherent without spinning. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this area and just kind of take away a few blocks and see what we have to work with over here. Maybe make a little spot for water and whatnot to possibly come on in. It's going to be a secret place. And that means that we're going to have to get rid of some of these sugar canes. Oh, I don't want the map. So it's going to come in this way, I think. We'll have little spots for water, too. It's going to be like a cave that has water going into it. Now, before I go any further, I'm going to go ahead and kind of block this off, because this is going to be where the water is running. I want to kind of meander it down a little bit, actually. This is going to run low soon, so it's going to be worthwhile to throw an enchant on this pick. In fact, it should be break. Okay, there it is. Go ahead and throw a torch in here just so that nothing surprises me when I come back. So these things I was talking about being useless, well, they're not. They're useless, but not for long. So the great thing about enchanting tables in this version of the game, 1.8, is that you can kind of see what's going to happen before you get it. So I want to get a nice pick. And I just realized something. I don't have access to the high-level enchants. Oh, well. Let's get a low-level one. That's nice. I could either go for an efficiency or an unbreaking. I don't think I get to have much of a choice. I kind of like an unbreaking just because it lasts longer. So I'll see what that does. Okay. That's fine by me. And while I'm here, who knows? Maybe I can get a faster axe. Cool. And Mr. Shovey Shove. A faster Shovey Shove. So I'm trying to make this look kind of like a natural cave. It's going to go down a couple levels, and then rest, and then go down a few more. Nothing too crazy, just, you know, nice little pleasant, kind of natural looking way down. And then around here, I think it'd be nice to have it go down even further, like some sort of a waterfall, maybe. Yeah, we're thinking big. So this ahead doesn't look like much, but it's going to be the big map room. So I'm going to clear this out in hopefully a timely manner. And we've found a cave. Well, this is a little bit unexpected. I'm not really going to do much with it. Maybe this could be useful later. It's kind of nice having a cave by secret passages. Gonna make a secret none of that. Enough of that already happens. Try to stay away from cliches. Alright, I'm not gonna really follow this too much further. Although it looks like there's light. No, that's just a different type of rock. Yeah, whatever. Doesn't really go any further. Alright, that's cool. All right, so here's the plan, man. Is that this is gonna go and it's gonna drop off here. So maybe I could even let that kind of come through and see what that looks like. Use the map. So that's gonna go there. Nice. And the path to get down is gonna go off to the side here. It's gonna be kind of a low path. It's gonna go this way. It's gonna wind a little bit. So it's gonna be kind of treacherous and a little strange. You're gonna be thinking, well, where am I going? This is just to kind of be silly in a way. I did not go down as far as I thought I would, though. So I'm gonna go ahead, and it's gonna go down even further. But in the meantime, that's gonna be the way down. I'm gonna bring this all down quite a bit. I'm gonna go ahead and give this the attention that I think I want it to have. All right, I think that's good. All right, I know there's lava nearby, but I haven't hit it yet, so I guess I'm not gonna worry about it. So this is what it's gonna look like. The path winds around, it comes out here. This is a waterfall that comes down, and this is gonna be the map wall. It looks a little blocky right now because, well, it is. But we can. That's going to be something that's going to be easily fixable. So for now, I want to see if we can get this map wall going, actually. All right, there we go. We got some more beef to cook too, in case that's something we want to be doing, which it is. In fact, if I want to replace any of this, I totally can. There we go. It's a lot slot. Le there, and there that goes. It's a lot less sloppy than having kind of weird looking stuff down here. I might even change this out. I think that looks a little better. All right, so the map wall. This is what it's going to be shaped like. And we are here. It's going to be that far down. So might as well not make it too hard to read. Let's just kind of use this general area here. So this map is probably going to go here. It's four tall with two maps there. That's the four. All right, so that's going to be generally what the map looks like. And now the fun part is putting them in. And this is where it helps to have it in this actual setup. So that. Oh, good. So it has you are here sort of a thing there. The only thing is, the taller parts are kind of harder to see because they're taller. So what I actually like to do is even give a little bit of a standing area to kind of even have it come in a little bit. Because if you really want to see the lower areas, you can just get close. But I like to do something kind of like that. have it kind of zigzag so you can hit these pockets if you need to see lower ones, but you can also see higher ones. So that's the place to sleep, that's the house, that's the house, that's the house. That's like the big kind of lake thing. Oceans out there, mountain ranges. That's that crazy rock thing. And I guess there's lava over there. What if we can see? Yeah, there's the frozen lake. Little thing. And that's all the unclaimed area on the other side of the river. So that's pretty cool. I like having those. So, to make this room better, I'm not going to worry that it's nighttime, because it looks like it's pretty darn nighttime outside. Instead, I want to look at this waterfall. Now, I'm going to give it an area to fall into, because it's going to fall into these. I'm pretty darn sure. Yeah, see, there's water there. So that's gonna go there. There's water there. And there. And I think I can take away those. I think so. Alright, cool. You can. Can I get this? Yeah. And I guess we could figure out what that waterfall is going to do eventually. Make it dressed up and look nice. What I kind of want to do is I kind of want to bring the ceiling down just over here. So by that, just to kind of block off this room so it doesn't look like it's a crazy cool area just yet. So I might do something like that. I can't want any sneak previews. So let's see if I can do this smartly. That might work. If you're outside looking in, I think you should only be able to see some of these things. So let's take a look. Alright, so cool. Looking in, you can't really tell where it leads. Alright, I like that. You can kind of see it, though. You can see there's something down there. That's perfect. If you can ever kind of manipulate what people look at when they see, when they walk through your stuff. That's always a pretty cool thing. Oh, let's see. I'm not sure how much more I want to take that down. I could do something like this. Just to, like, overkill, ensure that nothing gets seen. I'll just take away any spots that things can spawn. So the next part would be making this side of it seem natural. So I kind of, probably a dome shape thing going on.
So what I've done is I've brought most of the stuff from up there. I just left the little window thing and the door. I put them all down here. So this is the chest that had everything in it. And the two stoves are in there because they're making more smooth stone. So because I think we're going to need a little bit more. And I'm starting to think that for that room, I think it's got to look kind of like it fits to the area. Like, I'm starting to think, if I have those types of rooms, and they're like rooms that lead to portals to other worlds, They should somehow kind of mirror the world they're going into and exiting out of. So I'm thinking that since this is a mining town, that's going to have that sort of a theme to it. I'm not really sure how this happens. You know what I'm going to do? Actually, now I'm thinking about it. I'm going to make this so that you can't really swim down it. So this is going to take a little bit of finesse. I think if we have him there. Yeah, you physically can't swim down it now. Let's see if I can get somewhere where I can actually look at this without having to control myself. Okay. So you can tell it leads somewhere. I think I like that a little bit better, because then you have to use this path. Let's see, I'm going to make it look a little bit more natural by just kind of throwing in blocks every so often. Doesn't look bad. I think I could be okay with that. What I like about that is it's kind of hidden. Like, you wouldn't suspect it. You can't really, like, the sugar cane really does a good job hiding the cave, and you'd really have to be, even over here, to be able to kind of see that there's something there. So that's really cool. I think that's, having hidden stuff is always, that's always fun to do. It's kind of strange to see this place all cleared out. But I must move on. Alright, so I'm going to put a few support beams in here. Oops. I'm not going to be too... I'm not really sure my criteria for where they're going to be is. I want a few of them. I'm going to bring those up. That way we know that that's an important doorway. And I think I'm going to just fill this in with dirt for now. Because that door is not open yet. But it will be, you know, eventually. So I'm going to kind of fill this in a little bit more. Just to make it seem a little bit more natural looking. I want to say natural looking. This doesn't have to stick out quite as far. And now I want to make the roof look like it's actually being held up by those. So let's see if I can get some cross beams kind of going. Alright, now that I have those in, I'm going to bring the roof down to them, so to speak. At least right on top of them. Now you're probably thinking, what the hell is this guy up to? Well, patience. You'll see in due time. In due time. So putting the stone on top of those blanks, those wood blocks was just to make it spawn proof on the ceiling. Now everything else I do can be purely decorative. And nothing, there's no ledges up there. Except that kind of. That things can spawn at. Alright, so what I'm going to do next is I'm going to see if I can bring the roof down in strategic areas. When I look at this crossbeam right here, I think, well, it's pretty close to here, but the further out it goes, the more I think, well, how much is this going to be able to support? So I'm probably going to bring the roof down actually a little bit, kind of like this. So I'm going to do that right now. So I did that in kind of a wedge formation. I use very, very simple geometric shapes when I first start out, and then I sort of naturalize things afterwards. So I'm probably going to bring this down in a similar way. Alright, now at this point, if you take a step back, you can see that this is going to eventually have a smoother curve around. I'm going to do a similar thing as I see fit to these other, that I did with these, to all of the other areas of, corners of the ceiling. Alright, so if we look at it, this looks a little better, albeit a little bit blocky. So the next part is to kind of round things out and maybe sort of naturalize things. Love that word, naturalize. All right, I'm pretty happy with the roof in here. Now it's time to make the floor look better. So I'm going to take away this. I think what might actually help is if there's little patches in the ground where stuff had to be used to fix them. It's the way it's starting to look more and more like a mine shaft. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the gravel I have and kind of give it some character, if you will. We're going to obstruct the view right there so people see there's something over there, but do they know what it is? And as for this, I guess it should seem like it goes somewhere. You know, we can have it kind of go this way. And then it can look like it's going under. So maybe it could look something like that. Yeah, that looks interesting. So the water looks like it continues. Must be night outside. Or maybe not. Maybe it's just dark. That's kind of a cool effect. Alright, so that's a pretty good secret room, I think. That'll wrap up this episode. And the next episode... Actually, before I go into talking about what the next episode's going to be about, I wanted to mention that... As I'm sure you've noticed in this episode, I've been making more jump cuts. And in the first video of this series, I said that I wouldn't be doing that. I'd be trying to be continuous. I'm finding out that I really don't need to show every little thing I do. In the beginning, I felt I did, because that's a big part of survival. But after you start getting all the things taken care of, and it starts to get tedious, and I end up with videos that are like an hour long or more. I guess it's already almost daytime. I sleep so much I never get to see the sunrise. We can watch the sunrise over the over our town. So I've decided that it's okay to make cuts and stuff just for the sake of fitting more into each episode. I'm going to be happier because I get to cover more things, and maybe you guys will be happier for that too. And, you know, just that's the nature of this thing. It's going to start somewhere and it's going to evolve and hopefully get better as each episode goes. So with all that being said, I'm probably not going to show me harvesting the sugarcane and the wheat and feeding the cows all the time, but they're implied. Things will go on. But in the next episode, I think I'm going to work on putting more things in this area. Definitely going to upgrade the farm. So maybe I can get something redstone-y going on. I haven't done anything with that yet, so that should be fun. And this has been Red McNed. So long.